Hello everyone, welcome to Sir J. Matt World. So isang topic na naman ang ating i-discuss ngayong araw na to. At ang topic na to ay tungkol sa properties of parallelograms. So before we proceed in our discussion, huwag kalimutan na mag-subscribe sa aking channel para updated ka sa mga lessons na aking ina-upload. So kung ready na kayo, let's start. So we have here the property number 1 of the parallelogram. So it stated that any two opposite sides are congruent. Illustration, meron tayo dito, sabi dito, if A, segment AD is congruent with segment BC, so ito yung ating AD, tapos ito naman yung ating BC. So, as you notice, meron silang isang guhit, tapos isang guhit dito. Ibig sabihin, they are equal. Then, segment AB is congruent to segment DC. So, itong taas dapat ay parehas dito sa baba. Then, ABC is a parallelogram. So, in short, meron tayong, if segment AD is 5 cm, so therefore, yung BC natin is also 5 cm. Then, kapag yung AB natin is 10 cm, yung DC natin is also 10 cm. Example, we have here the figure, so we have here parallelogram CARE or parallelogram CARE. So the CE has the side of 2x plus 3 and AR has the side of 5x minus 12. So we have to find for the value of x dito para makuha natin kung ano ba eksaktong measure ng CE at saka yung AR. So in this case, RA or AR is congruent or is equal to CE kasi stated that any two opposite sides are congruent. So kapag sinabi natin congruent, this is A equal. Now, yung RA natin has the formula or has the side of 5x minus 12 is equal to yung CE natin is 2x plus 3. So, in this case, ito transpose natin yung negative 12 papunta dun sa right side and yung 2x papunta doon sa left side kasi combine like terms. So, magkakaroon tayo ng 5x minus 2x. So, from positive magiging negative and is equal to magkakaroon tayo ng 3 plus 12. So, from negative magiging positive. Then, simplify this and simplify this. So, 5x minus 2x is equal to 3x. Then, 3 plus 12 is equal to 15. Then, divide both sides by 3. Kasi kinukuha natin yung value ng x. Now, this will be canceled out. Kakancel to. Then, magkakaroon tayo ng x is equal to 15 divided by 3. The answer will be 5. Now, to check the answer, dapat sila ay equal. Kapag sinubstitute natin yung value ng x dito sa mga x dito. So, magkakaroon tayo dito ng 5 times yung value ng x natin is 5 minus 12 is equal to 2 times value of your x is 5 plus 3. Then, 5 times 5 is equal to 25 minus 12 is equal to 2 times 5 is 10 plus 3. Then, after that, simplify lang natin, magkakaroon tayo ng 25 minus 12 is equal to 13 is equal to 10 plus 3 is equal to 13. So, we proved that these CE and RA or AR are congruent. So, therefore, this is a parallelogram. Next property is property number 2. Stated dito sa property number 2, any two opposite angles are congruent. So, kung kanina opposite side, ngayon naman is opposite angle. So, yung nga palang ibig sabihin ng opposite, sila yung magkatapat. So, in this case, magkakaroon tayo dito ng or kabaliktaran, opposite. So, we have here the diagram, tapos we have here if angle A is congruent with congruent to angle C, so itong A nakatapat siya doon kay C. So, and angle B is congruent with angle B. So, yung B naman is nakatapat siya doon kay D, or in short, kung sino magkatapat, siya yung magka-opposite. So, yung A is opposite to C, yung B is opposite to D. Then, ABCD is a parallelogram. Now, in this case, kapag yung A natin has the 60 degrees, dapat yung C natin has also 60 degrees. Tapos kung yung B natin is meron tayong 120, dapat yung letter D natin is also 120 degrees. Then, kapag inad natin to, the parallelogram should have a 360 degrees. So 60 plus 120, that's 180. Tapos 120 plus 60, this is also 180. So 180 plus 180 is 360. Dapat yung sukat ng parallelogram natin, 360. Example, we have here the figure. So C-A-R-N-E. So the same. So yung C natin has the value or has the angle of 2x minus 4 degrees. Yung R natin has the 120 degrees. Then yung E natin is 3y plus 9 degrees. So in this case, magkakaroon tayo ng C is equal to R. So kasi yung C, ang katapat niya is yung R. Now in this case, kukunin natin yung measure ni C, which is 2x minus 4, substitute lang natin, is equal to the measure of your R is 120. So silang dalawa yung magkatapat, so therefore sila yung magka-equal. So in this case, yung 4, lalagay natin siya doon sa right side. So magkakaroon tayo ng 2x is equal to 120. So from positive from negative magiging positive. Tapos we have 2x, 120 plus 4 is 124. Then divide both side by 2. So pag dinibay natin siya both side by 2, so magkakaroon tayo na cancel this and cancel this, then magkakaroon tayo ng x is equal to 124 divided by 2. The answer will be 62. Then after that, kukunin natin yung value nito. So in this case, magkakaroon tayo ng 2x minus 4 is equal to 120. Then substitute lang natin yung value ng x dito. So magkakaroon tayo ng 2 times 64 minus 4. So itong pinalitan natin itong x ng 62. So from here is equal to 120. Then after that is multiply 2 times 62 is equal to 124 minus 4 is equal to 120. Then 124 minus 4 is equal to 120 is equal to 120. So opposite sides are congruent. So if this is 120, this should be 120. So yan yung property number 2. Next, property number 3. So any two consecutive angles are supplementary. So kapag sinabi natin consecutive, sila yung magkasunod in Filipino. So this is the diagram. So we have A, B, C, D. So magkaroon tayo ng angle A plus angle B. So yung A papunta dito plus B is equal to 180. Then from B to C, so B plus C is equal to 180. Then from C to D is also 180 kapag inad natin. Then we have also D plus A. So D papunta sa A, that's also 180 degrees. So we have here that kapag ito ay 60, yung angle A natin, the angle B should be 120. So 60 plus 120 is 180 degrees. Then yung kapag B to C naman, yung letter C natin is also 60, or angle C 60, kasi 120 plus 60 is 180, kasi property number 2, opposite angles are congruent. Then this is 120, so opposite angles are congruent. Then kapag meron tayong C plus D, so C plus D is also 180, then D plus A is equal to 180, kasi 120 plus 60 is 180 degrees. So example, we have here the same figure. We have here 2x minus 4. This 2x minus 4, ito yung sinolve natin kanina. This is 120 kasi opposite angles are congruent. So if this is 120, this will be 120. So ang kukunin natin dito is yung y, or yung angle E, the measure of the angle E. So in this case, magkakaroon tayo ng C plus E. So, from C, add natin kay C is equal to 180 degrees. So, opposite, consecutive angles are supplementary. So, as I said, nasolve na natin kung kanina, this is 120. Then, it will be satisfied the property number 2, opposite angles are congruent. So, this is 120. So, magkakaroon tayo na yung C natin, this will be 120. So, from here, instead na ito isulat natin na 2x minus 4, sulatan natin siya ng 120 degrees. Plus, yung angle E, will, this will be 3y plus 9 is equal to 180. Then, ilipat natin yung 9 doon sa right side and also yung 120 doon sa right side. Then, magkakaroon tayo ng 3y is equal to 180. So, from positive magiging negative. And from positive magiging negative also. So, negative one, minus 120 minus 1 minus 9. Then, simplify lang this. Simplify the right side. So, magkakaroon tayo dito ng 3y is equal to 51. So, 180 minus 120 minus 9 is equal to 51. Then, divide both sides by 3 to find for the y. Then, kapag divide natin yung 51 divided by 3, the answer will be y is equal to 17. Then, after this, is we can now find for the e. So, correction, this is y, not x. So, magkakaroon tayo ng, again, this is y, not x. It's typo error. So, magkakaroon tayo ng yung angle E is 3y plus 9. So, therefore, this if this is y, so magkakaroon tayo ng 3 times 17 because the value of your y is 17 plus 9. So, 3 times 17, the answer will be 51 plus 9. So, yung angle E is equal to 60 degrees. Now, to check kung siya ay 180 degrees, this will be angle C is 120 plus 60 kasi the angle E is equal to 60. So, 120 plus 60 is equal to 180 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. So, kung kukunin natin yung angle A, so this will be 60 kasi opposite angles are congruent. So, this is 120, this is 120. If angle E is 60, therefore, your angle A is also 60. Yan. Property number 4. So, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So, this is the diagram. So, magkakaroon tayo ng ito yung diagonal. Yung first diagonal natin is from A to C. And second diagonal is from B to D or from D to B. Pwede naman sila magkabaliktad. Then, this diagonal, these two diagonals rather, ay nag-intersect sa letter E or the point of intersection of the two diagonals is in the point E. So, andito siya. So, kapag nag-bisect, kapag sinabi natin bisect, nahati siya sa dalawa. So, itong A, diagonal AC, hinati siya ng DB or BD. Then, itong BD or DB diagonal is hinati naman siya ng AC. At karoon siya ng point of intersection dito. So, in short, kung ang A to E mo is 6 cm, dapat ang E to C mo is also 6 cm. So, A to E is 6 cm, then E to C is also 6 cm. Kasi, kapag nagkaroon siya ng bisector or bisect, mahati siya sa equal side. So, kapag kinuha natin yung length ng A to C, gagawin lang natin is to add yung AE plus EC. So, 6 plus 6, this will be 12. So, yung AC, yung length ng AC, diagonal AC is equal to 12 cm. The next is, kapag ang given dito is the from B to E is 5 cm. Yung E to D is also 5 cm. So, pag kinuha naman natin yung buong measure ng diagonal B to D this will be pi plus 5 only. So magkakaroon tayo ng 10 centimeter. Example, we have here the parallelogram CARE. Tapos, we have here from A to S, magkakaroon tayo dito ng 5x minus 4. Then, S to E is just only 4x. Nag-binisect siya or hinati siya ng diagonal CR. Then, point of intersection will ito yung S. Now, to find for the X, magkakaroon tayo ng AS. So, AS is equal to SE. So, in this case, yung AS natin is 5x minus 4 is equal to yung SE natin is 4x. Then, lipat natin yung negative 4 sa right side at yung 4x doon sa left side. Then, after that, kakaroon tayo ng 5x minus 4x is equal to from negative magiging positive. And from positive magiging negative. Then magkakaroon tayo dito ng 5x minus 4x, this will be x is equal to 4. Then after that is kunin natin yung value, or we have to check kung sila ba ay magiging equal. Just substitute the value of x to the given. So palitan natin ito ng value ng x, and also this the value of x, which is 4. So, magkakaroon tayo ng 5 times 4 minus 4 is equal to 4 times 4. 5 times 4, this will be 20 minus 4 is equal to 4 times 4 is 16. Then, 20 minus 4 is equal to 16 is equal to 16. So, therefore, this diagonals or bisected diagonals are equal. So, kapag kinuha natin yung measurement ng A to E, this will be, kung ito ay 16 at ito ay 16, magkakaroon tayo ng 16 plus 16. Ang magiging measure ng A to E, diagonal A to E, is equal to 32. Kasi 16 plus 16 is 32. Okay, next we have here the property number 5. So, property number 5 stated that, so this is the last property of the parallelogram. So, a diagonal of a parallelogram forms two congruent triangles. So, in this case, this is the illustration. So, magkakaroon tayo ng this is the diagonal. So, sabi doon, a diagonal. So, isang diagonal lang gagamitin natin. So, from A to C or diagonal A to C, ay hahatiin na yung parallelogram natin sa dalawang congruent triangle. Congruent means the same. So, ito yung unang triangle natin. So, triangle ABC. And second triangle is triangle ABC. So, this is the first triangle. This is the second triangle. So, magkakaroon tayo ng triangle ADC as congruent to triangle ABC. So, in this case, kung nagkaroon tayo ng diagonal, so, this angle is also bisected or nahati din siya. So, example, if this is 30, this is 30. So, ang tawag dito is, kumasin nyo, this is same color with this. So, ibig sabihin, they are congruent. So, ang tawag dito is alternating interior angle. So, kapag nagkaroon siya ng ganito, yung isa andito, yung isa andito, kunwari, yung given lang is meron dito. So, therefore, we have to conclude that this side or this angles is also 30 kasi siya ay alternating interior angle. The next is, if this is 30, this side, this blue is also 30 kasi the alternating interior angle also. Example, we have here the 4x minus 1. And this is 3x plus 11. Ang bisector dito is yung angle CR. Ito lang. Never mind the E to A. So, erase muna natin itong E to A. Pofocus lang muna tayo dito kay C and R. So, this angle is congruent with this angle. So, in short, Gagawin tayo ng ACR. So, A, C, and R. Kasi ito yung first triangle. Ito yung first triangle. Then, congruent to CRE. So, CRE. And this is the second triangle. Yung ACR mo is we have here the 4x minus 1 is equal to CRE is equal to 3x plus 1. So, gawin natin dito is lipat natin yung negative 1 doon sa right side and yung 3x doon sa left side. You will have 4x minus 3. So, from positive magiging negative is equal to 11. From negative magiging positive. Then, after that is 4x minus 3. This is 3. 4x minus 3x, this will be x is equal to 11 plus 1 is equal to 12. Then, the substitute to the given. Yung palta natin to ng mga x, itong x ng 12. Then, this will be 4 times 12. Yung x natin is 12 minus 1. Congruent to 3. Yung x natin is 12 plus 11. Then, 4 times 12. This will be 48 minus 1. Congruent to 3 times 12 is equal to 36 plus 11. Then, 48 minus 1 is equal to 47. Then, 36 plus 11 is equal to 47 degrees also. So, yun yung paraan sa pagkuha or how to solve for these angles. So, remember that this 4x is congruent with 3x plus 1 because ito ay alternating interior angle. So, kung dito naman siya napunta, ang magiging partner niya is yung dito sa part na yan. So, those are the properties of the parallelogram. So, let's have the property time to check kung ano ba yung property na applicable dito sa given. So, example, we have here the 16 and 3x plus 4 and y minus 60 and 56. Then, we have to identify kung ano ba yung property or properties na pwedeng i-apply to solve for the x and to solve for the y. So, bigyan ko kayo na 20 seconds para hulaan kung ano yung properties na applicable. So, ready? Okay, time's up. So, the property na applicable para ma-solve yung y and yung x is property number 1, stated that any two opposite sides are congruent. So, yung 16 and 3x plus 4, property number 1 yung gagamitin to solve for the value of x. Then, for the value of your y, is property number 2. So, any two opposites angle are congruent. So, ito. So, this is congruent. So, itong to solve for the y. Next, given. This is the figure. So, identify what property or properties is applicable to find for the x. Ready? Go. Okay, time's up. So, the property that is applicable to the figure is property number 4 to solve for the value of x. So, the diagonal of a parallelogram bisect each other. So, magkakaroon ka dito ng this is equal to this given. So, that's all. So, thank you for the time and watching my videos. So, hopefully na may natutunan kayo sa ating lesson. So, again, the properties of parallelogram ang ating topic. So, that's all.